Hello, welcome to another GoJS intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate the resizing tool and rotating tool GoJS comes equipped with. It will also demonstrate how one might wish to modify adornments associated with tools. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. It is also recommended you have seen our Tools Overview video before watching this. We'll explore Resizing Tool by way of example. We'll demonstrate how the tool works within the context of a vertical node template. When a part is resizable, the Resizing Tool will add an adornment containing 8 resize handles to that part when selected. Simply set a part's Resizable property to true, and we see that this is the case. The entire node's bounds are being resized. Dragging one of these handles sets the node's desired size property. You might want to resize only a particular object in the node. In our instance, maybe we just want to resize the shape element of our node. For this, you must specify the node's resize object name property and ensure its value is the same as the name property of the object in your template you want to resize. Let's set the name property of our shape to shape, then set the resize object name property of our node to shape. Then, when we reload the page, we see only the shape is resized when one of the adornment handles is dragged. That's because we set the shape to be the only object to be resized. This is especially apparent when you look at the placement of the adornment's handles. The bottom handle is not beneath the text block at the lower boundary of the node. Instead, it's along the bottom edge of our rounded rectangle shape. We can limit the minimum and maximum size for the resized object by setting the max size and min size properties. Let's set our shape's max size property to a new go.size value of 100 by 300 and its min size property to a new go.size value of 20 by 20. Now, when we resize our shape, it never exceeds 100 by 300 or grows smaller than 20 by 20. We can cause resizing to be multiples of a given size by setting the resize cell size property. Let's set our node's resize cell size property to a new go.size of 10 by 10. Now, we see that as we resize, the new size of our shape is always a multiple of 10 by 10, the resize cell size value. The default value for this property is not a number by not a number, which allows objects to be resized by any increment. Let's explore how we can modify the resize adornment template, that is, the adornment that houses the resize handles on a selected resizable object. All we have to do is set the resize adornment template property in our node template to some valid adornment. We must construct adornments much in the same way we construct any other part. We'll start with a spot panel, then add a placeholder. The placeholder will receive the size and position of our adorned object, in our case, the shape of our nodes. Since the placeholder is the main element of the spot panel, all subsequent elements in the spot panel will be aligned relative to the placeholder, and since the placeholder has the dimensions of our shape, all elements in the adornment will be aligned relative to the shape, our resizable object. If you need a refresher on part construction, go back and watch our Building Parts with GoJS videos. Next, we'll add two shape elements, which will act as left and right resize handles. One will be aligned to go.spot.left, the other go.spot.right. We'll set some common properties of both, stroke, desired size, fill, and cursor, the last of which we'll set to the valid string callResize, which will make our mouse point appear as a bidirectional horizontal arrow when hovering over one of these shapes. Now, if we reload the page, we see our selected node uses the new adornment we made as its resize adornment instead of the old 8-handled default one. The blue outline of our entire node is the selection adornment and has nothing to do with the resize adornment. We can turn it off by setting the selection adorned property of our node to false. Now if we look, we see only our custom resize adornment when a node is selected. Next, we'll look at the rotating tool. When a part is rotatable, the rotating tool adds an adornment containing one rotate handle a short distance from the object at the object's angle. Since the default graphObject.angle is 0, the rotate handle usually starts to the right of an object. Let's restart with a fresh auto node template and set its rotatable property to true. Load the page. We see one rotate handle to the right of our node. If we click and drag around, we see the rotating tool work its magic. The node rotates in response to our dragging of the rotate handle. You might notice the node is rotating around its top left point. That's because, by default, parts are rotated around the point specified by their location spot property, and, by default, location spot is go.spot.topLeft. If we want to rotate around the center of our node, set its location spot property to go.spot.center. Now look, the node is rotated about its center. Let's change our node template to use a vertical panel instead of an auto one, so now the text block appears below the shape element. Let's see what this looks like. Rotating the text might make it difficult to read, so maybe we only want to rotate the shape element. Just as with our resizing example, we can set the shape's name property to shape, then set the rotate object name property of the node to shape, so only the shape element will rotate when the rotate handle is dragged. Reload the page and we see that this is the case. The shape rotates, but the text block stays as it is. Often, you may want to rotate elements by a multiple of some number of degrees. This number is specified by the rotating tool.snapAngleMultiple property. The default value is 45. The rotating tool.snapAngleEpsilon property determines within how many degrees the angle of a rotating object must be to snap to a multiple of the snapAngleMultiple property. The default value is 2, which means that if we're rotating an element and it's within 2 degrees of some multiple of 45, it will snap to that multiple. Let's increase the snap angle epsilon property of our rotating tool all the way to 45. Remember, we can get a reference to our tools from the diagram.toolManager object. So, we'll call mydiagram.toolManager.rotatingTool.snapAngleEpsilon, then set that to 45. Reload the page. We see our shape rotates only within 45 degree increments now. That's because the snap angle epsilon property and the snap angle multiple property are both 45. So as long as the angle given by our dragging of the rotate handle is within 45 degrees of some multiple of 45, it will snap to the nearest multiple of 45. You can customize the rotate handle by setting a parts rotate adornment template as we did earlier with a parts resize adornment template. That's it for this video. To learn more, visit the intro page on Tools. We recommend you watch Tools, Relinking, Link Reshaping, and Tool Parts next. Head over to GoJS.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.